Miss again, this lucky Luciano, man. You know, I always want to say you're the coldest mouthpiece in the South, but one of the hardest workers I know. Tell these people what time you wake up in the morning.
I get up early, man. I'm an early bird, but I don't be out partying all damn night. I go to sleep early too, shit. You know what I'm saying? I be up early, shit. By 10 o'clock in the morning, I done knocked 3 tracks out. You know what I'm saying? These niggas sleeping in bed still. I done knocked 3 tracks out.
What's your secret, man?
I ain't giving up the recipe. You're going to have to pay for that. You know what I'm saying? Game to be sold, not told, man.
Is it safe to say part of your recipe is to wake up early in the morning?
Yeah. That's part of it. But you know what I'm saying? You just got to be, you gotta have it in you. It can't be on you. You know what I'm saying? You got to be born with this shit, man. Some people just got it. You know what I'm talking about? And you got to be real. You got to be real and be yourself. These motherfuckers can see through that shit if you ain't. You know what I'm saying? And that's it.
How do you like it when people say, do you embrace the Latin word? They say, oh, he's Latin rap. You know, somebody's like, nah, we rappers.
I didn't at first. At first I didn't, but now I'm forced into that box. So I'm like, fuck it, nigga, I'm gonna be the Latin rap star. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna be just some Mexican rapper that sits on the shelf. Nah, I'm gonna be a flamboyant fucking star. You know what I'm saying? Like a Latin one though, because whenever I first came into the game, I remember they did that, and I went to a high school that was like a black high school, Eisenhower, Acres Home. You know what I'm saying? Slim Thug, Lil Mario, and all J Dog. They all went to this same high school at the same time I went there. You know what I'm saying? So I was used to rapping around blacks and hearing. You know what I'm saying? It was just, that was the crowd that I rapped for, you know what I'm saying? So whenever that I got into the rap game, it was like they all of a sudden put me over here in this Latin rap game box, you know what I'm saying? And it kind of fucked me up. And I remember I did my first show at Sound Waves with Dope House, Carlos and Low G, Rashid, they was all there, and I did a show. And Charles Chavez, he was like, man, what's up? Well, like your show was, they weren't responding to it. And I was like, man, that wasn't my type of crowd. And he was like, what do you mean it wasn't your type of crowd? It was a bunch of Mexican kids. But I think at that time, the Mexican kids were, they were used to, they weren't ready for the type of rap that I was spitting. You know what I'm saying? I was talking about slabs and drank and lean, and you know what I'm saying, it was just different from what they were used to. You know what I'm saying? They were hearing Low G and Rashika on that way, and they liked it. It was tight. That was tight. You know what I'm saying? But that's what they were used to. So whenever I came out my shit, they were just looking at me like, what the fuck are we looking at? You know what I'm saying? They weren't ready for it. You know what I'm saying? Like I was that first Mexican down here with the Gucci shades and the diamond grill and the braids and all that shit. They had never seen no Mexican like that down here before. You know what I'm saying? I did that shit first. The Player Made Mexican, man.
And who was the originator of Player Made Mexican? Who made that name up?
I did. And then me and Bash did a song called Player Made Mexican. It was actually a song I had on my underground mixtape called Player Made Mexican. Where my Player Made Mexicans at? Where they at? And Bash liked it and said, hey, I want to put this on my album coming out. And so I took my second verse off and he put a verse on there. He put it on his album. So, you know, Bash a Player Made Mexican too. That he from the Bay. They Player Made up there, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. What's one of your most favorite albums that you had enjoyed making? That you is like that album right there was the one for you.
Probably my first one with You Already Know. I think because that was the first one I got. I was excited about making it because it was going in the stores. I got some money for it up front. They gave me an advance. I was feeling good about it. And I was hungry still, you know what I'm saying? So I had a lot of shit to say. So I think that was, I enjoyed making that one the most. I had a DVD with it. And yeah, that was the one.
What's your biggest hit to date that you would say for the streets or?
Man, I don't know, man. I got so many damn songs I record. Even when I gotta go do a show, I don't even be knowing what songs to put on the damn show disc because I got so many damn songs I be forgetting them. I don't even know. I don't know. I got too many.
Let me ask you this: what's your favorite song that you made?
I don't know. I might have one today that I like, and then tomorrow it'll be a different one. It just depends how I'm feeling that day, you know what I'm saying? I can't say this is my favorite song because it just depends how I'm feeling, what mood I'm in.
Are we going to see a Playmate Mexican 2 with you and Bash?
I don't know. We might. That's like asking, are we going to see a Throat Essays 4 with T? You know what I'm saying? It's like, we already did it. You don't got to keep doing it. We did it. We did it for the fans, you know what I'm saying? It was like, it ain't like we a group, you know what I'm saying? we doing our own thing.
So how did you and GT Garza end up doing this Latin royalty?
Well, I mean, me and GT, I've known GT for 10 years, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people think GT is new. That nigga been around. He been hustling since he was a little youngster, you know what I'm saying? And he's been since he was like high school, you know what I'm saying? He's been out here grinding. And just now he's getting his shine because he kept on working. He kept on mashing. He never gave up. He didn't go off. Some people get tired and they go and get a job and they just stop. They're like, fuck this shit. I got to pay my bills. You know what I'm saying? But he stayed in that damn studio. You know what I'm saying? He kept on mashing. He stayed in the studio. And now he's where he's at. You know what I'm saying? Now he's getting his proper recognition.
You know, look, we go back, and, you know, I didn't watch you go up in this rap game. And, you know, being... You know, you at the top, man, you know, of the game, you know, for the Latin rap, bro. And how do you deal with the jealousy and envy, though, man, as you was coming up, you know what I'm saying, coming up through these streets and you know, people being jealous, envious, you know?
I really don't really trip on it now because I really don't got shit to prove now, you know. But back when I was young, I would really, you know, I would let it get to me and I would address it or I'd, you know, just act a fool sometimes, but that's because I felt like I had shit to prove. I felt like I was that nigga, but nobody knew, you know what I'm saying? So I felt like I just had to show my ass sometimes, but you know, I'm past that. I really don't be tripping on niggas hating or talking down and all that. I don't give a fuck about all that shit. It don't bother me, you know what I'm saying? Buddy, they ain't paying my bills, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it really don't bother me.
A lot of, in this rap game, you know, it's a lot of shit that be going on, man. And, you know, you seem to really stay clear a lot of shit, but, you know, you quick to put a motherfucker in his place, man. Too, as well, you ain't gonna just, not hold your peace. You feel me?
I mean, if it's somebody relevant, if it's somebody who's just, you know, a nobody peon talking shit, I'm gonna ignore him. But if it is somebody, you know, with a little name for themselves, you know, I ain't finna back down for no man, you know what I'm saying? I will, you know, get on your ass, you know what I'm saying?
So do you have any other plans besides just right now, what you're doing? What's your plans for the future goal? What's your future goals right now?
I don't know, man. I think I wanna find a young artist I could, you know, help groom into this rap game. I've tried with other artists, but a lot of times people, they either got drugs or they got kids or they got, you know, they got just different things going on with their life or they gotta get a big head real quick or just shit happens. So I ain't found that right artist yet, but I plan to, you know, I want to mold an artist and show him things that I went through so he wouldn't have to make the mistakes that I went through, and you know, show him the do's and the don'ts in this game and how to be successful.
So how did the SPM versus get leaked?
I don't know how they got in Carolyn's hands. I know that a few got in my hands. You know, first let me say this. You know, whenever SPM first got locked up 10 years ago, I could count damn near on one hand how many people stayed down at Dope House. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't got to say no names. People know who was there and who wasn't there. You know what I'm saying? Before he got locked up, everybody was there. You know what I'm saying? But when he got locked up, it was only a handful of people that stayed down and stayed waving that flag and yelling free SPM, even though we got backlash because of all them charges he had on his back. But we still rep for the Mexican and made it cool to say free SPM. Now everybody yelling free SPM, putting free SPM on their album covers, hashtag free SPM on tweets and Instagram and all that shit. But back then, motherfuckers wasn't doing that shit. They was, you know, oh, I don't know if I should say that. I don't know how people are going to take that if I'm, you know, representing for the South Park. You know what I'm saying? We the ones who made that shit cool to say free SPM. So for motherfuckers to come now and act like they've been down the whole time. You know, 10 years later, all of a sudden want to yell free SPM. I find that shit kind of fake, you know what I'm saying? And that shit ain't cool. So, no, I don't know how the verses got in Carolyn's hand. I know how verses got in my hand, you know what I'm saying, and got on my album, you know, shit. But I'm lucky. I'm, you know, there's, I you know, I paid my dues, you know what I'm saying? I was there when, you know, say motherfuckers was going to war at Dope House, when limos was getting shot up and shit, you know what I'm saying? I was there, you know what I'm talking about? So, motherfucker can't tell me shit, man. You know, that nigga Payne called me up talking about, do you know somebody want to buy an SPM verse? I tell him, hell yeah, I know somebody want to buy an SPM verse. Shit, who wouldn't want to buy an SPM verse? So, shit, he sent me the email. I add my verse to the track and sell it for double what he asking for. Kept half money for my verse, sent him the other half. Whatever he did with the money between him and Dope House Records. Shit, I ain't got nothing to do with that, man. I'm a hustler out here trying to eat, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to the big homie, ain't nothing but love.
So you got any last words for your fans?
Appreciate y'all staying down all these damn years, keeping me fed, man. I'ma keep supplying y'all with that dope, you know what I'm talking about? Y'all ain't gotta go too far and look for it, man. I'ma keep putting it in y'all face. For all the upcoming rappers, man, if y'all need digital distribution, holler at me, man. I'ma put you right, I'ma have you on the right track, you know what I'm saying? GT Digital Distribution, me and Goldtoes got it rocking, know what I'm saying? It's going down. If y'all need to book me, I really don't like even doing fucking shows and shit, man. But if y'all drop off that bag, holler at Goldtoes and, you know, we can make it happen. 415-706-3704. Or if you need that fire-ass feature, I got you, man. You'll have that shit back within 24 hours. Be like, God damn, that nigga wrecked that hoe.
This ain't what you used to, now you rocking with the top tier. This another level of the game, my nigga, no, you have no idea. Drop a check, go book my flight, then poof, watch me up here. Got a blind nigga right now, talking about goddamn, lucky I see ya. It was vacant, I had to take it, I paid my dues for this G.